Welcome to a proof of the theorem, if one side of a triangle is longer than another, then the angle opposite the longer side is greater than the angle opposite the shorter side. So if we had a triangle like this, notice the side opposite angle C is 21 units, and the side opposite angle B is 12 units. Therefore, by this theorem, the measure of angle C would be greater than the measure of angle B. And since the side opposite angle C is actually the longest side of the triangle, we could also conclude that the measure of angle C is greater than the measure of angle A. Notice the side opposite angle A is only 15 units. Let's see if we can prove this theorem. So we're given that the length of AC is greater than the length of AB. We want to prove that the measure of angle B is greater than the measure of angle C. This is kind of a tricky proof. What we're going to have to do here is pick a point X on side AC to make triangle ABX an isosceles triangle. So let's get started on that idea. Number one, we'll state the given that the length of AC is greater than the length of AB. And now we're going to locate this point X somewhere in here, such that the length of AB will be equal to the length of AX. Therefore, we're going to have an isosceles triangle on the right side. So for step two, we'll locate point X the length of AB will be equal to the length of AX. And the reason for this is the ruler postulate. So now we know that triangle ABX is an isosceles triangle. And the reason for this is just the definition of an isosceles triangle. Remember, if we have an isosceles triangle, the base angles are congruent and therefore equal in measure. So to keep track of all of these angles, let's go ahead and number them. Let's call this angle 1, we'll call this angle 2, and we'll call this angle 3. Again, because triangle ABX is isosceles, we know the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle 2. This is by the base angles theorem. And now we're going to create some equations that involve angle 1, 2, 3, B, and C. The first equation is going to involve angle 2 as an exterior angle of triangle BCX. So if angle 2 is an exterior angle, the measure of angle 2 would be equal to the sum of the two non-adjacent angles, or the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle C. And the reason for this is the exterior angle theorem. Now, using statement 4 and statement 5, we can perform substitution for the measure of angle 2. We can say the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle C. Again, this is by the substitution property. Now let's take a look at the angle B. Now it's also true the measure of angle B would be equal to the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle 1 based upon how we set this up. And this would be true by the angle addition postulate. And now we want to be able to create an equation here that involves both the measure of angle B and the measure of angle C. And we can do that now because we can perform a substitution for the measure of angle 1. For statement 8, we'll have the measure of angle B equals the measure of angle 3 plus, we'll replace the measure of angle 1 with the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle C. And again, this is by the substitution property. I think now we have enough information to prove the measure of angle B is greater than the measure of angle C, because in order for these to be equal, notice how we have to add the measure of angle 3 twice to the measure of angle C. So the measure of angle B must be greater than the measure of angle C. And this would be by definition of greater than. I hope the flow of this proof makes sense, and I hope you found it helpful.